Spesu Dendi is a hell of a show, but trying to explain why to someone who hasn't seen it is kind of difficult. It's directed by the guy that did Cowboy Bebop and
it's kind of like they gave Cowboy Andy
his
own
real
show.
Continuity, and every episode is a super wild concept and has crazy fucking characters.
Dandy has really cool
It also
hair.
Has a really original take on how varied aliens can actually be in
the characters are really unique and
they go to a restaurant that is a not so sly reference to Hooters, indicating that titty is valuable in all universes, as is probably
also,
fact.
Look at the fucking colors!
So what makes Dandy so dandy? For me, all of that stuff is alright, for sure, but Dandy is one thing before anything else, and this is kind of a spoiler, but don't worry about it, because it actually has, like, no bearing on the actual show, but it's actually really smartly written. For those that are unaware and haven't watched Dandy, throughout our series, Dandy and his crew perish or get imprisoned in another dimension frequently, but instead of resolving these issues, the next episode simply brings you back to the cockpit of the Aloha Way, with Dandy, Meow, and QT doing their thing as normal. The first time this happens, people are like, wait a second, hang on, what? Now, what Space Dandy does at its core is parody old-school sci-fi TV and movies, bringing up and lampooning concepts and ideas from anything from Star Trek to throwing a Romero title card at the end of the zombie episode, which was pretty cool. But from a writer's perspective, how do you execute this? Is it simply an episodic show with no explanation, or do you somehow find a way to link this idea and make it an ongoing theme in the show? The answer is simple. You work out multiverse and timeline theory to your advantage, baby. Hey, everybody, it's spoiler time. If you want to watch this show, go away. You can come back later if you want. I don't really care. So after the off-the-wall episodic adventures of Dandy and crew, in the series finale, God himself reveals to Dandy that he is something of a fixed entity in existence. Now, what that means is no matter where he is in time, Dandy is Dandy. Zombie timeline? Zombie Dandy. Cowboy timeline? Probably Cowboy Dandy, I don't know. Star Trek The Next Generation? Dandy would be totally out for drinks with Q. Actually, maybe Q is Dandy, who the hell knows? Our universe? Somewhere out in the stars, Dandy is riding the cosmic waves. He exists in every timeline, but retains his skill sets that every Dandy in every timeline has. Now, why this is genius is not only does it explain the semi-episodic nature and loose continuity of the show, it also shows why Dandy is the way he is. He's shown to have a pretty decent grasp of warp tech, which shows he has a high understanding of physics and can do a bunch of crazy stuff like surfing on the concept of fucking time. Now, most people would watch that, like me, and think, oh, this show's just silly, I guess. But when you take into account that Dandy is this extra chronological entity, the fact that he can do that kinda has a really different weight when you think about it, and makes you realize how much attention they gave to the concept of the series. What was just a bunch of short entertaining stories is now a timeline-hopping reverie fueled by quantum mechanics. And what's even more crazy is 5 years later, as I'm doing research for this, I read on Reddit that the ED was talking about this the whole goddamn time, and I had no freaking idea. Oh my god.